everyone, Mr. Farmer Kid here. I'm just bringing you a tractor that I just did some detail work on. Firstly, really small cosmetic work, which would be right here, where I just did a little work. I'm not particularly pleased with it. I think I'll do a better job. And using some heavy paint to do it. But until then, looks good for now. And next, put flasher bars on this. So, if you don't know, flasher bars are for when you're going down the road at night. It marks where your duals hang out. So, those turned out pretty good, I think. Okay, and next is right here. It's a straight pipe. I would have liked to do a curve on it, but I'd have to order it from Tractor Fab, because when you try to bend this by yourself, it ends up just pinching where you're bending it. Even if you grab it at several places, you can't get a nice smooth curve, so unfortunately I'd have to order for that. Then next, right here on the back, I put a new hitch on it. Just a small piece of brass with a hole drilled in it, bent around underneath. But the old hitch used to go from there over to here, the whole span of this back PTO area, which was way too huge and bulky, and it looks ridiculous on every level, so I just decided to make up my own. Here you can see on the bottom, there's a curved piece that curves back around that plate, which holds very well. So, there's a tractor. Came out pretty good. I'm deciding whether or not I'm going to put mirrors on it right now. I think I actually might. I just like the idea of it, because if you got flash bars on it, that's probably because you do a good amount of road travel with it, as far as maybe you're doing slurry spreading, or you know, you have to travel from field to field to do field work and cultivate, etc. So I think I am going to put mirrors on it. I'll give you an update on that. I'm going to have a farm update here soon. And I was thinking to do this, cut that out. Here, I'll show you. Cut this out all the way up to the frame. That hard with the lighting here. All this in here. From here over to here. Because that's supposed to be the drive shaft for the four-wheel drive. And that's just bulky. It just looks like a giant piece hanging down. It kind of bothers me. So I was going to cut that out and use a piece of brass, a pipe kind of like this right here I used for a straight pipe. I was going to do a detailed shaft so you have space between the frame and the shaft going through. I wasn't even going to try to jam it in here and have it go in there and try to get it to spin. But I decided against it because I'll probably have to tear everything off if I did that. So, where I do think I'm going to do that is with this tractor. I'm going to get realistic back wheels for it. I might just do something with the fronts. I don't want them to be too different from the back. I mean, I like the tread and everything on that, but I don't particularly like the fenders, but I'm probably just going to end up leaving it because everything's pretty straight and nice. And this also has fenders, which I might leave, but I might end up changing that because, as you can see, they're pretty wobbly. Here on this tractor, they're not too bad at all, but oh well. So what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to cut the try to shaft out and put my own there so that I can try to maybe get to spin, or I'll probably just end up gluing it in there because that'll be a lot of work. But for both of these tractors, I'm going to cut the weights off and put tractor fab weight boxes, or put a weight bracket on the front and get weights that you can actually hang on there that you can't order from tractor fab. This tractor right here is a 4650. That's a 47. And this one's a 4755. That's a 4650. So, this one right here, I think I'm just going to leave with singles. But I'm probably going to get tractor fab with stubs hanging out. I might even have attachable and removable tools. And on the back here, I'm probably going to also cut this off. I'll probably do that now after this video, actually. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed, and I might as well show you this. This was a 5088. It's a known number, but I was attempting to make a cabless one, but it didn't turn out very well. I do have the operator station somewhere around here, not sure where, but I was going to do a cabless cause, and try to base it off a 3088, but it didn't work out because right here you can see when I was cutting it, I got down into the fender where the fender would be a little much. I might try to save it. You can see it's a little rough there. So, yeah. So that's just some projects I got going here. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed. I'll get to uploading this and work on these for a while, except the 3088. I'm gonna have to get another tractor or figure something out with the fender, but kind of a learning curve for me right now. So here I'll probably cut the front weight off, try to cut the belly out or the drive shaft out to put my own in, and cut the real rear hitch off to put a new one in there. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this. Let me know if you want more. Please give me a thumbs up. Really motivates me, helps me out to do this and make more videos. So hopefully I can get back to my pace. And Caseman MXM125, check him out. I expect you to start making videos again because you make really good videos, and I don't think there's, you know, be a shame if you stop making videos. But yeah, so thanks for watching, and stay tuned.